A major feature was announced for SharePoint last week. I think this is going to be the biggest announcement all year in terms of SharePoint. I'm going to break down what this thing is, what it does, and how your users are going to be using it. Let's get into it. So this new feature is called Click to Copilot. It's going to allow you to have a Copilot in SharePoint on a specific site. In fact, it's going to be on every site. Your site owners will turn this thing on and configure a default Copilot. It's going to pop out on the side of the page, similar to how the details pane looks right now for if you look at a web part property or file properties. And it's going to give you the ability to have a custom Copilot that you can chat with and ask information about the site you're on. It's going to be grounded on the site information by default, but you can further customize this thing. In fact, users will be able to customize this directly. You're going to be able to, if you have edit permissions on the site as a regular user, you're going to be able to create your own custom Copilot on this site. It could be grounded on the entire site. You could be grounding it on specific files. So here's kind of what you can do with this thing. Suppose I've got a set of policy documents on a SharePoint library. Let's say it's the HR site. I can take specific documents. I can select them. I'll be able to click one button in the command bar, and it will create a custom Copilot that will answer questions about just those specific documents. So this is incredibly powerful. I can pick, like I said, specific documents. I can pick a folder. I can pick a specific document library. The choice is mine as the user for how I want to create my custom Copilot. Now, this is going to be limited to documents specifically. You're not going to be able to ground on list data. Maybe that'll come in the future, but I honestly don't know that we would need that. Let me know in the comments if you think we do and why. Another thing users are going to be able to do is they're going to be able to go up to the top bar and click on a button and choose which Copilot experience they want. You can choose the site default one. You can choose your own. And I'm even seeing a picture of Copilot for Microsoft 365 in there. And with one click of a button, you're going to be able to switch which Copilot you're using on that site. And this would be a personal thing. This would be what you want to use on during your visit. Site owners will have the ability to click on and off the different Copilots that are on that site to make different ones available to users. So you can have one that is the default one for the entire site. So people can ask questions and summarize information on there, whether that's a site page or that is a document or a set of documents. You'll be able to offer specific ones, maybe just on particular libraries or on subsets of files. All those types of options are going to be available that the site owners can make available to users, or users could just make them available for themselves. But it doesn't stop there, because when you're creating this particular Copilot, when you're creating your own custom Copilot, you'll be able to customize the welcome message that appears to users. You'll be able to customize the behavior of this. How friendly is it? Maybe it's sarcastic. That's probably what I would go with. Maybe so you can customize the personality of this thing. You can change which documents it should be grounded based on. You can add third-party ones as well, but you'll be jumping into Copilot Studio to customize it that way. But it'll be really easy because there's a button right at the bottom of the page to customize your particular Copilot in Copilot Studio. You could also change the starter prompts, what people call the zero prompt experience, so that if someone's not really sure what to ask, what to give as a prompt, or you just want some shortcuts essentially to be made available to your users, you'll be able to specify starter prompts that someone can just click on and jump straight to the response for that Copilot. So there's a lot of really nice quality of life features that this can provide, and I see a lot of benefit. Now, Click to Copilot is not just going to be for SharePoint. It's going to come to Viva Connections as well, because as you know, that dashboard is actually hosted in SharePoint. So in the Viva Connections example, you're going to be able to add an adaptive card using the card designer, bring in a Copilot, a custom Copilot that was created, and add some additional functionality using Copilot to your Viva Connections dashboard. So that's a really, really neat thing. I've got to spend some time in there to really see what the best use cases of that would be. And just, you know, have some fun with it. And then the last big thing for this that I know that the developers out there are going to really love is that Click to Copilot will be available in SharePoint Embedded. So there'll be a React component that you can add to your application that serves as the front end of SharePoint Embedded. And by the way, if you aren't familiar with that, I've got a video that will explain the whole thing and walk you through setting up one with a demo website. But developers are going to be able to use this, drop this component on there, and then make a custom Copilot available to their application, grounded on their SharePoint embedded data. Really cool stuff. So that's a big breakdown of the news. Now, this isn't going to be coming until later this year at the earliest, I think. So we've got a pretty good wait before we get our hands on this. I think they are starting a preview before then. So hopefully I can get into the preview program. I can start to show what this thing looks like and how it behaves. But until then, we've had the screenshots I've been showing that Microsoft showed at Build. So there's a lot to take in from what this new feature is going to contain. There's a lot of things that the admins are thinking about as far as how can we control this and you know, govern from a governance point of view. What is the implication of Click to Copilot for tenants? So it's just some things to think about. Let me know what you think down below. Is this a good feature? Is it a bad feature? What concerns do you have at the moment? Let's discuss it in the comments. And if you want to see my video that covers SharePoint Embedded, then you can click into this video to get started. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. If you've made it this far and hit that thumbs up button, I'll see you on the next one.